Good morning. This is All India Radio, Kohima. The morning news read by Ketholeno. Network of Nagaland NGOs on Drugs and AIDS Organization and NAGADAO has appealed to Nagaland Legislative Assembly NLA Speaker Sharingan Longcomer to continue providing political leadership in dealing with HIV/AIDS and other public health issues in the state. In a representation addressed to the Speaker on behalf of 48 organizations, and NAGADAO yesterday said that Nagaland continues to have one of the highest prevalence rates of communicable diseases like HIV, viral hepatitis, TB, etc., and non-communicable diseases like cancer, mental ill health, poor sexual and reproductive health among the adolescents, which was a matter of serious concern and required urgent intervention and redressal. Concerned over the disbandment of the Legislative Forum on HIV/AIDS in the state, it said the situation points towards a worrisome state, especially due to lack of political guidance, leadership, and engagement by the elected members of Nagaland. And NAGADAO therefore called upon the legislators to provide matured political leadership to address public health and save precious lives and protect the vulnerable population of the state. The centre has announced the third stimulus package of 900 crore rupees for the Mission COVID Suraksha, the Indian COVID-19 Vaccine Development Mission. This grant will be provided to the Department of Biotechnology, DPT, for research and development of Indian COVID-19 vaccines with end-to-end focus from preclinical development through clinical development and manufacturing and regulatory facilitation for deployment. It would consolidate all available and funded resources towards an accelerated product development. The Ministry of Science and Technology said that this will help accelerate development of approximately 5 to 6 vaccine candidates. This will also ensure that these are brought closer to licensure and introduction in the market for consideration of regulatory authorities for introduction in public health system to combat further spread of COVID infection. Serum Institute of India, SII, will apply for emergency authorization of COVID-19 vaccine in next 2 weeks. This was stated by the chief executive of the institute, Adar Punawala, in Pune on Saturday. Serum Institute of India is the world's largest vaccine manufacturer by volume. Pune-based drug maker partnered with global pharma giant AstraZeneca to produce COVID-19 vaccine by University of Oxford for low- and middle-income countries. Dubbed as Covishield, the COVID-19 vaccine is currently in the phase 3 clinical trial in India. Punawala said, Covishield is a highly effective vaccine against novel coronavirus. He said, India will be given first priority for the delivery of the AstraZeneca Oxford vaccine. Guru Nanak Jayanti is being celebrated across India today. Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu has greeted the nation on the occasion. In his message, Naidu said that the founder of Sikhism, Guru Nanak, has remained an icon of truth, compassion, and righteousness through his noble life. He said his teachings have universal appeal and would forever inspire us to follow the paths of compassion and humility and to show respect for all humankind, irrespective of caste, creed or religion. Vice President said that Guru Nanak Jayanti is always an occasion for family and friends to come together and celebrate. But this year, given the unprecedented health emergency due to COVID-19, he urged his fellow citizens to celebrate the festival by adhering to COVID health and hygiene protocols. Australia defeated India by 51 runs in the second one-day international for the three-match series at Sydney Cricket Ground yesterday. After setting a target of 390 runs, Australia restricted India to 338 for 9 in 50 overs. With this win, the hosts have now taken a 2-0 unbeatable lead in the series. In the opening game of the three-match series on Friday, Australia defeated India by 66 runs. The third ODI will be played on December 2 in Canberra. And as the nation fights COVID-19 pandemic, let us all remember to stay safe and protected by following these three simple steps. Wear a face mask, wash hands frequently with soap and water or use hand sanitizer and follow social distancing norms. With that, we come to the end of morning news. Have a nice day.